Satan attacks you because you're God's child, and he hates God's property. Satan attacks you because you're the light of the world, and he's the prince of darkness. Satan attacks you because you're the truth, and he's the father of lies. Satan attacks you because you're a soldier of the cross. You're anointed. You have the word of God. You have covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. You can take the sword of the truth of God and attack the gates of hell. You're a threat to him. You can only have one chance of survival. Put on the whole armor of God and fight back. Take the word, take the blood of the cross and the authority of Jesus' name, and drive demonic goons back into the back alleys of hell, because the victory is ours through Christ the Lord. God has given you authority. Use it so that you can have victory and peace in this life.
Really, I believe there are seven pieces of armor. I'm going to tell you briefly what they are. He says you need to make sure that you stand firm in verse 14. Gird your loins with truth. He says then you need a breastplate called righteousness. But he doesn't stop there. He says you need something for your feet. They better be shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Then he says you need a shield, and it's called faith. He says in verse 17, you need a helmet. You need something to guard your mind. You need a helmet called salvation, and you need a sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And while most people stop there, the Apostle Paul does not. He said, even though these six things are important, you need one more thing. In verse 18, he says, and pray. So pray. If you want victory in your marriage, would you make sure you are a man or a woman of prayer? If you want victory, teenager, in your high school or student at your university, then you got to become a person of prayer. If you say you want to live victoriously and abundantly and yet you don't pray, then I don't believe you.
A spiritual realm that is actually, honestly, more real and more important than this realm. It's just that we ignore it because we can't see it. But it's there. We are in a war. We are soldiers in the army of God. And Jesus is the captain of the host. He's given us his name. He's given us his word. He's given us his blood. And when I finally began to learn, when somebody began to teach me that the devil was behind most of my problems, some of them I was created myself, but the devil was behind most of them, that I had authority over him. God has given us weapons, and he's given us armor. We need to know how to use our weapons, and we need to make sure that we are wearing our armor on a regular basis. Spiritual warfare for spiritual people. How many of you have had it with the enemy and you're ready to learn how to fight him and win the war? All right.
Do it in God's strength. Be strong in the Lord. Say that with me. Be strong in the Lord. Be strong in the Lord. This is God's fight. It's not yours. It's God's victory. It's not yours. It's God's glory. It's not yours. It's God's kingdom. It's not yours. It's God's strength. It's not yours. Put on the whole armor of God and fight. And fight to win. Because the victory is ours through Christ the Lord. You can never exhaust God's resources. You can never exhaust God's resources. Because he can do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think. You can see his mighty power. But when he gets through, he's not exhausted. He has much more strength ready to give you from day unto day. He can defeat any giant that's before you. He can produce dreams in the desert. He can produce manna that will fall from the sky. He can send 12 tongues of fire in the upper room. He can walk on the water in the Sea of Galilee and salvage you. The thing that you think is about to destroy you, he can use it for a sidewalk to save you. When you grow weary, he can make you to run like Elijah 40 miles before the chariot. When you grow faint, he can give you strength. He can send you power that you can't begin to touch. You cannot exhaust God's power. Our God is an awesome God. He's full of grace and truth. He's the Almighty El Shaddai, the conqueror of death, hell, and the grave. He's the conqueror of sickness and death. He's the conqueror of powers and principalities. He's the conqueror from Calvary. He's the Lion of the tribe of Judah. He's the Lord of glory, and he's coming soon with power and great glory. This is about the eternal souls of men and women. This is about your soul. sons and your daughters. This is about the future of this nation. It's time for those who name the name of God to suit up and show up. This is a fight to the finish, and I intend to win it with the help of Almighty God. Put on the whole armor of God and stand beside me and take the word of the holiness of the Father. Fight the good fight of faith. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. And for those of you who name the name of Christ, stop allowing Satan and his demonic dudes to destroy your marriage. Put on the whole armor of God and fight back. Quit allowing him to attack your health. The Bible says by his stripes we are healed. Quit allowing him to attack your finances. The Bible says God will rebuke the devourer for your sake. He will make him give it back to you sevenfold. Stop allowing the devil to rob you of your peace, because Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace. Stop allowing Satan to rob you of your joy. In his presence is the fullness of joy. Do you want it? Then fight for it. Do you want it? Then fight for it.
Stick your cock up her ass, you motherfucking worthless cocksucker.
Be silent. This is This is DJ Tony Torres, the Master Mixer on the Death Squad.
What is relevant, but anything beyond that is dangerous. He's a liar. The demon is a liar. He will like to confuse us. But he will also mix lies with the truth to attack us. The attack is psychological, demon. And powerful. So don't listen. Remember that. Do not listen.
Thank you. cheer from DJ Tony Torres mixing on the deck wall.
Torres, the Master Mesa on the deck quad.
Give her what she wants.